3 months ago, I started making a film about old people. They were a pretty lonely bunch.
I'm depressed just living like this.
I mean, at my age, I'm not happy. Don't get it wrong.
And also pretty angry.
This should be allowed. Should not be allowed.
They don't look after the old ones like they should do.
Who'd have thought they'd become an international pop sensation? This is the story of how a bunch of British pensioners made the whole world listen.
Yeah, let them see that older people can do things. Don't put us in the dustbin. We're not ready yet.
Show us the moves.
Well, you see, I'm a lady trying to teach you dancing, and it's wrong. Because I'm taking you my way.
Right.
If you can judge a society by how well it treats its old people, I've always suspected we'd be in trouble in this country. I spent 3 months travelling up and down Britain, visiting old people stuck in tower blocks and care homes. Like this one, where I met 89-year-old Evelyn, a former payroll worker. She's one of the hundreds of thousands of old people shut up in care homes and out of sight.
Do you get a bit bored here, then?
Oh, we're bored to death. I'm bored. I get bored to death with anything.
So you've always been very active, then?
Yeah. And that's when I was thrown into this life. It's kind of... I've got used to it.
It's a world that feels closed off from society, where daytime TV constantly blares out. Dinner is served at 5 o'clock, and life centres around sitting in a chair in the lounge. Even those fit enough to live independently feel increasingly isolated. Many old people have hardly any daily contact with their neighbours or relatives, and there's little to entice them out of the house. I started my OAP journey by meeting a seasoned pro of old people's homes, someone who's never really settled into that institutionalised way of life.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Tim.
I'm Winifred.
Hello, Winifred.
For my sins.
For you, many sins?
Yes.
Yeah.
Once she was a journalist and crochet expert. In later life, Winnie's become an authority on old people's homes. She's lived in 16 of them.
I like a change.
Okay.
But I think the next one will have to be the last. Because, you know, my age.
99?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes, it reminds me of the story. What's this? 99 bump. 99 bump. You've probably heard it.
I don't know.
Centipede with wooden leg.
Winnie's had enough of her latest care home. Fed up of being surrounded by other residents too poorly to talk to, she's on the move. Again.
We've only just begun.
Is she your best customer?
Yes, one of the most regular ones, definitely, anyway, yes.
Has it been very isolating for you inside?
Oh, it has, yes. I've always felt and been the odd one out because I like to discuss things with people, but there's nobody here in the staff, in the residents or patients who is interested or can do it.
So, how do you feel about leaving this place?
Nothing but joy.
Really?
We've only begun.
It's all the rising sun.
So it's back to one of her previous 16 care homes, which in retrospect wasn't so bad after all. And it's back to a few old friends.
Mr. Stan Rossington. Now that's Iris. These two, Joan. And Kat. You know, I feel like a young girl, all excited. Now, isn't that nice? Nice, isn't it? Oh, and there's a good mirror. There wasn't a decent mirror at the other place. Oh, well, do I look a bit chatty?
Glamorous.
Oh, I'm not fishing for compliments, don't think.
You got one.
Oh, yes.
What's it been like for you? What's it been like for you in the past few months?
It has been
being in that home.
A sheer boredom. I felt like a caged lion. It's not like me to be depressed, but I certainly was depressed. Now, don't be shy if you want to spend a penny.
I've spent.
Have you?
I've spent.
After that tea, I shall need another one, but not yet.
Me too.
Winnie may be an expert on care homes, but Patsy Feely knows a thing or two about another institution. Fortunately for Barclays, Patsy's now retired. A career armed robber, he spent decades in and out of various prisons. But nothing prepared the old lag for his time in care homes after suffering a stroke.
Slow down. How many robberies have you been involved with?
Oh, well, all my life I've been this in my life, you know, burglaries, robberies, and I was put away when I was 10 years of age in the East End, like, for breaking and entering places.
How are you treated in prison compared to how you're treated in an old people's home?
We're treated worse in homes.
Really?
Yes. Yes. I tell you what, I am an hard man. I'll fight anybody. I don't care who they are. Right? You bring them in here, I'll fight them. They want to cut me? And bullets, lumps of wood, no bricks, anything. I'll do it. But I cried when I see people, the way they treat old people, old girls sitting there crying and shitting themselves and pissing themselves, and they fell on the floor and couldn't get up, and they're going, nurse, can you help me? Can you help me? Yeah, all night and all day. Can I have my pills? And that hurt me. I took some stick in my life. I took some stick. I've had some fucking wallopings. I've not won every fight. I'll tell you, that made me cry while seeing it. Treating old people like that? You don't treat old people like that. You know, give them a bit of decency. Give them a bit of respect. You know what I mean? Like old people. Shame on.
You can see why Patsy would plump for prison over an old people's home. The food, for one thing. More is spent on some inmates than those in care homes. The freedom. Prisoners get fresh air daily, guaranteed. Old people can go months without getting outside. But more fundamentally, whilst prisoners are covered by the Human Rights Act, residents in private care homes aren't. That really affects the ability of old people to complain. Anyone kicking up a fuss can be kicked out, even if just a relative complains.
Old lady, shame on you.
Practice now.
I'm not pressing anything I should.
No, don't worry.
Winnie's heard that prisoners have more human rights than she does, and she's about to do something quite unruly about it. Posing as my sound man, she's come to collar some politicians. The plan is simple. Winnie's got to get close enough to some unwitting MPs to try and steal their watches, and then demand to be arrested.
In this life, one thing counts, in the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You got to pick a pocket or two, you got to pick a pocket or two, boys.
You got to pick a pocket or two.
Hello, it's George Osborne. Mr. Osborne, this is Winifred.
Yes.
She's 99. She's here from BBC Current Affairs.
Right.
Winifred's doing a bit of work experience with us, because, you know, at 99, you're not too old to hold a broom.
Not going to let you run off without listening to me. What time is it?
Well, it's just coming up to 4:15.
Could I borrow your watch? Just for about 10 minutes? Could I?
Well, I need my watch because I'm about to do a radio interview.
Well, there's a reason.
What's he going to do with my watch?
Could I borrow your watch? Yeah.
What's he going to do with my watch?
Thank you very much. Now, I've stolen your watch.
Yes.
I think I'd rather go to prison than go to a residential home. So will you make way for me to get into jail?
Well, the only thing is
I can live on the
However, I don't want you to go to jail, and B, I'd like my watch back because it was a birthday present for my family.
I stole the watch because I felt I'd be better off in prison than I am at the moment.
Right, well, you make a point.
Have human rights.
You didn't steal my watch because I gave it to you. But
have you ever been mugged by a 99-year-old before?
No, I haven't. No.
Thank you.
Good luck with everything.
Bless you.
Glad I got my watch back. Bye bye.